Hey, what's up? My name is Taclys, and today I'm doing the results for my giveaway competition. Now, I was going to have video of every single world that was entered, and a little critique, and me playing through it, my thoughts and whatnot, but I looked through the footage, and I'm not sure exactly what happened, but they all got messed up. Every single clip was recorded incorrectly, which was unfortunate. So I guess I'll just tell you guys what the results were. First off, I'd like to say thank you guys for submitting so many things. I got over 20 submissions, and I'll be listing off most of the ones that I played. They were all varying degrees of quality. Some of them definitely surprised me in terms of their ingenuity or their quality or anything like that. Some of them had some issues. There was one world in particular, that there was a bug in the code that kept creating a character model and made the game lag a lot, which I was going to take a look at, but I couldn't. So anyways, all the worlds were fun to play, and they had some interesting concepts, and every single world that I played did not have the third person camera, so we didn't have to worry about rejecting anyone due to not following the rules, so that was great. Now I'm going to really quickly read a list of most of the worlds that I've played or were submitted. This isn't all of them. There were a few others, but let's see. We have Adventure Quest World, Adventure Run, Trolls and Moles, Ancient Building Props, a Nook, Bowling Arena, Bowling Mania, I'm sorry, Kria Arena, Defend Python Base, FPS Arena, Galactic Rampage, Knight's Adventure, Spark in Space, Super Spark 3D, Tacmol Giveaway, The Pit, World War Z, and Zombie Cam Template. So I really had a hard time. For the record, all of those are going to get a code. It'll either be the Operation Mole or it'll be a troll code. I'll take a look through the comments to see if any of those have a preference. So you don't have to worry. If you've submitted a world, you're going to be getting a code, and you can expect to receive that within the next 2 to 3 days. It's going to take me a little while to send out that many codes, but you should be receiving them in the next few days. It was tough for me to decide a winner on these worlds, because there was a lot of diversity here. It's not like that you're comparing Call of Duty and Battlefield, how they're very similar concepts and ideas. It's like comparing, let's see, it'd be like comparing Call of Duty and Battle Block Theater. They're so vastly different, it's hard to compare them because there are some really creative ideas that were used here. But I managed to get 3 winners and 2 honorable mentions, and those honorable mentions, I may or may not be sending out a bonus with them. We'll see. So our three, well, let's do our honorable mentions first. Our first honorable mention was the FPS Arena. I believe that's what it was named. Pretty much, you had an arena, you were in first person, enemies spawned, you killed the enemies for crystals, you went back to base, you upgraded your character, your guns, your abilities, and all that, and you got to go back into the arena and continue doing that. And that was pretty awesome. I really enjoyed that. The other honorable mention was the Bowling Mania. It was such a good concept and pretty well executed. It felt a lot like playing on the Wii a little bit, not obviously without motion controls. The thing that made this world not a winner was, unfortunately, the pin physics were a little wonky. I had a really, really hard time getting a strike, even when the ball hit exactly how I wanted it to. But other than that, it was a great concept. Really enjoyed both of those worlds a lot. So for our 3 winners, and these 3 are worlds that had a high level of finish to them, or were very fun to play, or were well optimized and followed the parameters of the world, and were just overall a solid game that I would go back and I would replay. And I'm not going to do these in any specific order, because I'm not making a big deal out of the competition bit, since everyone gets a code. We're not going to have a first, second, and third place. These are all the 3 winners. So those 3 winners are, actually, hang on, I wrote down the wrong one. Let's see. Our first winner is Spark in Space, which was a really fun world. Hopefully I got the right name on that. Spark in Space was a game where I believe you were a collapsed star, and you were flying through the galaxy, and trying to fly through other stars to gain mass while avoiding other interplanetary objects. And it was super fun to play. It was a little hard avoiding some of those interplanetary objects, but it was, I've never played a Project Spark World like that. It was completely different from anything I've ever played. The art style, the controls, the concept, it was just an excellent world, and I would definitely go back and replay it. Another, let's see, the Pit is our other winner, and that was a world where you're in an arena and you open various doors with various degrees of strength of enemy. And I really enjoyed the combat in this world. Now, to be fair, I wasn't very good at it. And I think with a little more time, I would have been better at it. And I'd love to see the strafe or dodge mechanic added in, because blocking only gets you so far. But I did appreciate the different types of combos that they had. The setting and the aesthetics of the world were well done. And everything made sense pretty well. So overall, that was a pretty fun world to play. And that one actually deceived me, because I was sure when I took a look at the code, I was going to find the third person camera. But nope, they used a boom camera and they made it just behave exactly like the normal third person follow camera. So that was a fun world that I definitely enjoyed. And our other winner was Defend Python Base. This one may be, it was really fun, though when I came to the end of it, I wasn't quite sure if I was at the end. But pretty much, you're at a sci-fi base, there's lots of aliens attacking, and the goal is to kill the aliens and do a series of small objectives. And I like that there is that there was objective text on the screen. I like that you had to do a little bit of puzzle solving and find the right rooms. The first person gunplay was pretty good, and it felt good, even though it was using the default Project Spark first person shooter brain. It felt good, and the enemies felt pretty well balanced and all that. So I had a lot of fun with that. Got to the end. It had a nice feel to the world. It had med packs and teammates that followed you around and all that kind of stuff. So I really enjoyed that. So those are our three winners. I will be messaging those codes to people via Xbox messaging, and they will be our three winners will get both codes and 10,000 credits. If the winners have either of those two codes, then feel free to pass on the code that you already have. Like, if you already have the Troll Bridge pack, give that Troll Bridge pack to someone else, because you won't be able to use it, so why keep it? So, that pretty much concludes the results for this. I'm sorry that the footage didn't work out. I'd love to post the footage of all the worlds I played. I had a ton of fun playing all these worlds, and some of them were really interesting, some were kind of dorky, some I got to laugh at the little bugs and issues that they had, but overall it was good. So thank you all very much for submitting. I will be getting these codes sent out shortly. And if you're wondering why my video count's been a little bit low lately, I talked a while ago that I'm fixing up a house and I started a full-time job, so that slowed down my video count some. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten about you. We are in the end game stages of getting my house done. We're working on it super hard, a lot, and I'm going to be moved into my house before the end of the month. So if my video count's a little low, that's why. I'm working 5 days a week full-time on my job, and then I work Saturdays on my house, and sometimes I work on my house in the evenings after my job, so I'm putting a lot of work into my house right now. But should be done soon. We have internet installed, which is one of the most important things, you know. 30 megabytes per second. Yes! So, we're almost done. Thank you all very much for your patience. I'm going to try to get another video or two done this afternoon while I have time. Once again, thank you all for submitting. And be sure to go over and thank Project Spark and Team Dakota, because they supplied these codes to me. They're super awesome about that. So, yeah, you can go tweet them. They're the coolest devs ever. They're super nice. Yeah, I'm sure anyone who's been in the Project Spark community for a while can say that as well. So thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys later.